So you might be wondering why this video is popping up and the Miura has a different color again. Now, in the last episode, I painted the Miura in a green color. It's a green bluish color, actual Lamborghini color from back in the day, and I posed the question if you guys liked the color. I did not, and I still don't, but you guys seem to all like it, except for this one guy who didn't, and then all the others seem to like it again. But, I'm willing to compromise. I'm building this kit the way I want it to be, and I decided to repaint it. Now, that doesn't mean that I don't want to build it again in the color that you guys want to see it in. So, feel free to contact me, thescalemodelingchannel@gmail.com, if you want to send me out a kit to build in this specific color, or maybe another color. Now, the plan is not to send them all back to you guys, it's actually to keep them and keep them together to display at shows in all the various colors and combinations that you guys and me can think of. Now the kit is not that complicated, so it should be able to be built in a couple days without too much hassle. Now, I'm not going to fully detail all of them, of course. The engine is hidden, so I won't really be paying any attention to that. Maybe just a couple variations on the interior color and mainly just focusing on the body itself. So before the actual last video went live, it was already repainted. However, one of you guys was onto me. I don't know how, but he's right. I will be repainting it in a similar color to the one from Black Sabbath guitarist Tony Iommi. Now, I'm just going to start on the repaint process and show you guys how I'm doing it. I'm not going to use isopropyl alcohol or strip the entire paint job off, as that's way too much work, takes way too long, and I don't really think it's worth it as the body is nice and straight. So I just scribed out the panel lines again to remove some paint. Now be aware I will be losing a couple small details here and there, some of the vents on the roof and some minor details on other places on the body, but I'm not really too worried as I really don't want it to stay this green color. So after scribing out the lines, everything was nice and straight again. A couple lines were a bit buried in paint, so they weren't as straight as they were before, but it's still acceptable. So I dusted it all off and moved it in the spray booth to apply a couple coats of primer before I could apply the paint itself. From here on out, it's pretty much business as usual. I just let the primer dry for about 5 minutes in between coats, and then applied a second coat. The second coat was more than enough to completely cover the green color, and for me to move on to the next stage. As the clear coat underneath was super, super smooth, I did not really need to sand the primer whatsoever, as that is also nice and smooth, along with that clear coat underneath. After the second coat of primer, I set it aside for about 10 minutes, cleaned out the airbrush, and then filled it up with a light blue from Zero Paints, moving on to those hard to reach, easy to forget spots, and then a couple light coats on the rest of the body. first coat is on, the color is covering super nicely, and I can move on to the second coat after about 5 minutes to finish the color stage off. With the color now applied to the body, I'll let it dry for about 30 minutes before moving on to masking it up and then painting the silver bottom areas. The silver was applied in a couple coats, and then I carefully started removing the masking tape before I could move on to applying the clear coat. The masking is removed and the contrast is nice with the silver and blue in my opinion, and I'm kind of liking this color already. So I cleaned out the airbrush, mixed up the clear coat, and started applying it again on the hard to reach easy to forget spots first, and then a nice thick coat on the rest of the body. The first coat is on and it's laying down super nice and smooth, so another 5 minutes of cure time in between before I started applying the final and second coat of clear. The second coat is finally applied and it looks nice and smooth all over the place. The vents on the roof are a bit covered as I mentioned before, but that's pretty much the only detail that was lost. A couple panel lines are a bit jiggly and wiggly, but not too much of a worry for me, as I really do love the way it came out with this color instead of the green. Now again, as mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you want to see the green one come back, send me an email, send me out a kit, and we will work something out for an entire collection of Lamborghinis on some shows and stuff like that. If you guys don't want to send me out the kit and are actually happy with the color on this one like I am, just feel free to leave it this way. Let me know down in the comments below what you think of this repaint, and also if you'd like to see some others in the future.